You are surrounded in a vast open sea of golden brown sand dunes. You can almost see the heat around you as the sun glimmers in the sky. In the distance, you hear the vicious cries of a lone raptor. You catch the occasional glimpse of a tumbleweed moving from the corner of your eye. Welcome to the Sahara Desert. With a total area of 9 million square kilometers, the Sahara Desert makes up the most northern third of Africa. This makes it the world's largest desert, being roughly the size of the United States, with the desert's highest point being Mount Kuzi, and its lowest being 133 meters below sea level. One would assume that it being a desert, the Sahara would be nothing but sand. In reality, sand dunes only make up 25% of the total area. Having less than 10 inches of yearly rainfall is what classifies the Sahara as a desert. Due to the latitude of the Sahara, it is a subtropical desert. This is the hottest and driest type of desert. The word Sahara is Arabic and means desert when translated into English. The Sahara Desert has a lot more life than one would first think. The plant life includes a wide variety of grasses, trees, and shrubs. Things get far more complicated when talking about the animal life. The Sahara has a wide range of mammals from almost all sizes. This includes larger animals like Barbary sheep, Dorcas gazelles, and ostriches. Smaller and medium animals from this region include sandboxes, Libyan striped weasels, hedgehogs, and Ambis baboons. The Sahara has many creatures that belong to the sky, such as a variety of owls and vultures. Smaller animals include lizards, chameleons, frogs, and toads that live near the few lakes of the Sahara. In some lakes, even crocodiles can be found. The various creatures from the Sahara have needed to adapt and overcome to survive the harsh conditions of the desert. Even though the size of the Sahara is similar to that of the United States, its population is nowhere close. Excluding the Nile Valley, the Sahara is estimated to contain 2.5 million people. This averages out to less than one person per square mile. The majority of these people lives in cities near a lake or a reliable source of water. Some of these big cities include Tripoli in Libya and Cairo in Egypt. Now, thanks to modern technologies, humans have been able to tap into water reservoirs deep underground, known as aquifers. Due to global warming, rainfall has become less predictable than ever in the Sahara, making tapping into the aquifers ever more important. There is another lifestyle in the Sahara that is entirely different from that of the big cities. This is the nomadic lifestyle. There are roughly 200,000 remaining nomads in the Sahara Desert area. Through herding animals like goats, nomads can produce things like milk and butter. These people will travel between water sources, using one until it's nearly dry, and then moving to the next. This way of life is extremely dangerous and challenging. Years ago, the Sahara looked nothing like it does today. At this time, the Sahara was a lush and green savanna. This section of time is known as the African Humid Period. Scientists first found out that the Sahara was once green by looking at nearby deep-sea settlements west of the Sahara. Drawings on cave walls found by scientists kick-started the research on historic Africa. These drawings showed animals that cannot be found in the Sahara today. Scientists believe that change in the Earth's tilt and orbit over time caused the Sahara to dry up. At this time, there were river systems connecting the Sahara. Lake Chad was the largest lake in the world during this period. It was known as Lake Mega Chad and was bigger than all the Great Lakes combined. Traces of fishhooks, fireplaces, and hunting tools can be found all across the Sahara. During this time period, The Sahara was home to animals like giraffes, hippos, turtles, and a wide range of tropical fish. People from this period lived together in big cities. The remains of some can be found buried in the Sahara today. The environment at this time was great for growing crops and could support large numbers of domesticated animals. The Sahara Desert is a majestic and mysterious place full of life, from the plants and animals to its people's diverse way of life. The Sahara Desert is always changing, but for now, the sun is setting over the monumental sand dunes as an ever-moving caravan of camels travels into the distance.